Hey, hello guys. Good morning everyone. This is Priya from Alpha group of. Now the second chapter, second page. Nisha and Kavita met each other often and became good friends. Kavita had decorated her house with expensive furniture. She had many dresses. Manish had expensive cars too. From her childhood, Nisha had lived a simple life and disciplined life. She was never influenced by these amenities, but as time passed, she was under its influence and developed the passion of acquiring comforts like Kavita. And now children, here Nisha and Kavita are neighbors, right? Now Nisha and Kavita met each other often as they are just beside each other's house. As they were neighbors, they used to meet regularly. And Kavita's husband Manish is earning so much money, right? So Kavita's house is full of expensive furnitures, costly furnitures. Kavita is having so many dresses, modern dresses, and then she was having so many jewelries also. But Kavita, you know, Kavita comes, she from the childhood. Nisha came from the middle class family. She knows how to live a simple life, and Nisha's parents taught her how to live a simple life and a disciplined life. So Nisha was already used to that. But after some days, when she was moving very close to Kavita, when they became so close, after seeing Kavita's lifestyle, Nisha also got influenced to the rich lifestyle. Later, she also felt that she needs such rich, luxurious life. Nisha also thought she needs a luxurious life like Kavita. Now, the growing needs and rising desires of Nisha forced Rakesh to work more to earn extra money. He ate at times, spent sleepless nights. His health deteriorated due to overwork and insufficient food. Rakesh was forced to buy commodities beyond his financial capacity. After some days, they were burdened with debt. They lost their family peace. Their financial condition was very poor. Nisha had to starve for days. Okay, now what happened is, when the desires, when Nisha is wishing to get more and more, like so many expensive things to live a luxurious life, Nisha started forcing her husband Rakesh to give more money to buy so many things which are beyond their level. Now Rakesh, in order to satisfy his wife's needs, he used to work day and night. He will not eat lunch, or he will not take food on time. He will not sleep. So he lost his sleep, he lost his food, and also he lost his health also, only for one cause, that is to earn more money which will satisfy Nisha's needs. She used to buy so many things which are not necessary, first of all, but which shows her richness. Later, after some days, to buy all such unnecessary commodities, this family, because they were not able to meet the financial capacity for their needs. Later, what happened? They were burdened with debt. They used to take so many debts from others, so many debts to fulfill their desires. Later, the peace of their family were lost. They lost the peace. And also, after some days, they don't have income. Even if they have income, they have to pay all the debts. And they were in a place where they can't run their family. So later on, it affected their health issues also. And now, Nisha has not even, she don't have even food to eat now. Before, when she was satisfied with the simple life, she had all the things. But now, after buying all the things and getting more burdened with debts, Nisha is starving for days. she is not having food to eat also. They were in such a poor condition, from the middle class family to the poor condition. Okay. And next, she became the victim of depression. Rakesh has started a new business which was established after 2 years of hard work. He began to earn much money and took his wife to a good hospital to cure her depression. He also bought a new car to make her happy, but to no avail. She didn't eat food on time. She became so weak that she was not able to even speak properly. Ultimately, she died. Nisha could not get any opportunity to experience the happiness that was coming her way. Poverty is no crime, no richness a virtue. So children, now the saddest thing happened is, now when she met the stage of very poor things, when she met the poor stage of life, now Nisha went into depression, that the stage, the level what they are now is everything because of her. So she started thinking about her thoughts that she is the only reason for such condition, for their family situation. She went into depression. She was not eating proper food. She was not sleeping, always thinking negative things. But once they were in that situation, now again Rakesh started his hard work. Rakesh, again he started doing hard work, and later within 2 years he started his own business, and without giving up he worked day and night, and again he achieved his goal and he was succeeded in his new business. He was succeeded in his new business. Now he is having more and more money. He is earning more. He even bought a big new car, and he thought that this car will definitely make Nisha happy. But as Nisha is in depression stage, this thing, this situation, this scene didn't make her happy. And now when Rakesh showed the car also, she was not happy. Now he is having more money. He took Nisha to many big hospitals to cure her, to make her come out from the depression, but of no use. How much whatever he is earning, the amount of money and anything, and also the doctors also not able to cure Nisha's depression. Later she stopped eating food, she stopped speaking to everyone. She was in always depression, and later ultimately she was dead. Ultimately she was dead. And when she was living a simple life, she always decides for a luxurious life. At that time also she was not in a peace of mind. And now when she got the luxurious life, she had no chance, she has no opportunity, she had no chance to live that life. She had no chance to experience that happiness of her own money. And she was able to not experience the happiness which she is going to come in the future. So poverty is not a crime, children. And richness is also not a crime. But the way we take it, what we are having, is only the thing which maintains humans' physical and mental strength. Okay. A poor and humble man can also lead a happy life if he does his duty sincerely and lives by honest means. A right-minded man must possess courage to live honestly within his means, rather than live dishonestly upon the means of other people. He must not pretend to be richer, but rather be satisfied with what he got in life. So children, here, a poor man and humble man can also lead a happy life. Only thing is, we must be sincere, we must be truthful, we must be honest, and whatever the things we are doing individually for ourselves or for others also, we have to maintain our genuinity while we are treating with others. So this is the way where even a poor man also can lead a a simple man also can lead a happy life and virtual life, like a luxurious life in virtuality, rather than acting as rich fakely or living on others' money, trying to cheat others, being dishonest, being untruthful. Rather than having all these negative characters and leading a happy life, if we stop there and we take our life positively with truthfulness and also honest behavior, we can lead a happy life even when we are poor. Okay. So the main moral of this lesson is we should be happy and sincere honestly with what we have. And these fonts which are in this blue color font, these blue color fonts are the takeaway home points. It means these points are the moral points which we have to take home. We have to take it to our mind, and the rules which we have to follow in our life. Okay, first one is all people are not equally fortunate. So the luck will not come for everyone equally. Even though some work hard, they can't earn more. So luck is only for someone only, not for everyone. But the hard work and sincere will reach everybody. Everybody's that will be taken into notice. Our sincerity will be taken into notice. We should always remember your limits and capacity. It means we have to all, whenever we are buying something or when we are ordering something or when we are mingling with a group of people or when we are using our words, when we are using our tongue in a speech, we have to always remember our limits and our capacity, and according to that only we have to take another step. Okay. Now, few are born with a silver spoon, whereas others lead an average life. So only some people will be, only the children who are born in rich family are maybe the fortunate things. But only those children are like silver spoon born babies, and maximum of the people are leading average life. It's not a new thing, it's not a, like it's not, how we can say, it's not a mistake of our side, right? And then a right-minded man possesses courage to live honestly within his means. Right-minded means always uses his courage to live honestly with his own efforts. We must apply sincerely efforts. We must apply sincere efforts to perform any work, but we have to accept the result without being disappointed. So everybody have ups and downs in our lives. Everybody will be facing all the problems in our life, but whatever the thing, we must not get disappointed and discouraged. We have to lead our life perfectly with sincere efforts, and we have to express our work sincerely, truthfully. And the result, whatever it may be in a high level or whatever it may be to the low, we have to accept the result because it was done by us. So either it is a positive or negative, when the result comes with our own sincere effects, we have to take it happily and never get disappointed. So these are the five takeaway points which we have to take to our hearts and safeguard it. Okay, children, hope you all like this lesson, and then as usual we don't have any question answers in this moral science book in this lesson. So fill up true or false and choose the correct answer. I'll be just marking in the textbook, I'll take a snap, and also I'll post it in the group. Okay, children, so That's all with this lesson. And this is Priya, your favorite teacher, I think so. I think I want to be your favorite teacher, and I hope that I'm your favorite teacher. And then thanks for being with us. This is Priya signing off from Alpha Group of Institutions. Thank you guys. Bye.